Good morning, students. Today we are going to study our new chapter, chapter number 7, algorithm and flowchart. So in this video we are going to study about what is algorithm, what is flowchart, how to prepare a flowchart, and advantages of using a flowchart. So first we'll study about what is algorithm. An algorithm is a step-by-step procedure in a logical order to solve any problem. An algorithm can easily be converted into a computer program through any programming language. In simple words, you can say that in your day-to-day life, whenever you have to solve any problem or to do any work, you have to follow a step-by-step procedure so that you can get the best results for it. In the same way, a computer also solves its problem in a step-by-step procedure to get accurate results. An algorithm and flowcharts helps to create a computer program in a step-by-step manner. As you can see in your diagram, algorithm goes in a four steps. First, you have to implement it. Then you have to do the experiment. Then you can design and analyze your problem and solve it with the following steps. An algorithm can also be said as an input which gives an output. It is also used as a preparation of a sequence by step methods to work on the input according to which the computer prepares the output. So now let's calculate average of two numbers. But how to calculate average of two numbers? Idea: by using the algorithm, we'll follow the following steps. Step 1, turn on your computer. Step 2, enter the first number. Step 3, press the plus button. Now the step 4, enter the second number. Press the equal to button to display the sum. Now the step 6. Now divide the sum by 2 by pressing slash. Now the step 7. Press the equal to button to see the average. So now you can see that the calculation of two average numbers has been calculated. Now let's come on our second topic. What is flowchart? A flowchart is a graphical illustration of an algorithm containing step-by-step instruction written inside shapes to solve any problem. The purpose of flowchart is to make the program easy to understand in any programming language. As you can see the symbol and purpose of flowchart. The first flow lines is used to connect the symbols. The terminal symbol is used to start, pause or halt the program. The third one, the input and output process, is representing the information entering or leaving the system. Fourth, processing, represent arithmetic and logical instruction. Fifth one is your decision making, represent a decision to be made. And last one but not the least one, your connector. It is used at the end of the page and at the start of the another page to indicate the continuity of a flowchart. With the help of these symbols, you make your programs, and it is very easy for you to make your program. Now see how we'll add two numbers. First, we will use the terminal box so that we can start our program. Secondly, we'll use our processing box in which we write our first and second number. Now we'll input our numbers 1 and 2 in our input and output box. Then we'll write our number in the process box, that is sum is equal to A plus B. Then our sum will be displayed in our output box. Then we'll stop the program and our addition of two numbers program will be done. Now we are going to prepare a flowchart to compare two numbers A and B and display the larger number. First, we'll use the terminal box and start our flowchart. Secondly, we'll use the input and output box so that we can input our number A and B, which will be compared. Thirdly, we'll use a decision box so that we compare the number 1 and number 2, which one is greater in both of them. Fourth, we'll see whether the statement A or B is true or not. The system will display A and the arrow will directly go to the terminal box to stop. Fifth, if A is not the greater than B, then the statement of the decision box is false. The system will now display B. After displaying B, the next box is the terminal box which stop the flowchart. So, with the help of flowchart, we can prepare various type of flowcharts. Now, our topic is advantages of using flowchart. First, we can make a graphical representation. Secondly, we can show our steps that are clearly outlined and properly checked and rectified. Third one, we can use our logical steps so that our procedure can be done in a step-by-step illustration. Doing step-by-step method in a flowchart will help in understanding the problem better. At last, we'll see the advantages and disadvantages of flowcharts in some key points like better communication, time counseling, and etc. So here we end our chapter.